do need to meet the criteria.
So I might not get the therapist.
You might not, no.
Would you come and bring a meal on a wheel to my home?
That's right. I don't think that you would be able to receive one.
Okay. Where are these meals created?
They're created at Valley Park Manor Nursing Home. And so indirectly, that's related to the hospital.
I see.
So some of the meals, some of the entrees do come from the hospital.
Right.
But they're prepared at Valley Park Manor, which is located in Fairview.
Yes, right. And let's see. Over the years, you've probably had quite a turnover in volunteers.
And actually, no.
Oh.
We, of course, always get new volunteers, which we need.
Yes.
And we have 110. But some of them have been with us for 20 years and others for 10.
Wonderful.
We just have wonderful drivers.
Wonderful.
And I can call them anytime and they come, rain, shine,
yes.
Slippery roads, doesn't matter, they're
mm-hmm.
there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just wonderful.
So the rewards for the volunteers, as here at Shaw Cable, is really providing a service in the community. Otherwise, this would not even be possible without those volunteer hours. And we're looking at between 1 and 1.5 hours on that day that's been specified per driver.
Exactly.
So it's not a big time commitment.
No. It's usually the meals are ready to leave the nursing
mm-hmm.
home by 11:30.
Right.
And we carry them in a heater. It fits on your car seat. And
mm-hmm.
you get your instructions and away you go.
That sounds like a good service and a good time. And I don't know if there's anything else that we might want to cover or need to cover there.
Well, I would like, you know, people to think about it,
yes.
and if they're at all, I might just add that some of the families will buy gift certificates.
What a great
idea. To get them going,
yes.
and once
yes.
they're receiving the meals yes. and they see the benefits.
Right, yeah. You might just mention too, Marg, about the payment idea. You mentioned earlier that it would be once a week that it would be paid for.
Only the Friday drivers
right.
collect, and it's either yeah. weekly or monthly, and they pay cash or by check.
Sure.
Whatever.
So it's an easy system, and they don't have to be fumbling for change every day to pay the pizza man.
No, that's right. That's right.
But that would be set up in advance, and the client would know what to expect each time. Well, thank you very much for coming down.
Thank you for having me.
We appreciate you coming and sharing that need on Shaw Cable and Live Connections. And we know that the viewing audience out there, there'll be many people that maybe have not been aware of the program before, and this would be a great opportunity for you to get involved in a very worthwhile kind of volunteering service. So do take that into consideration and give them a call at Meals on Wheels. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And now we have a real treat in store. We're going to get ready to see the Country Pride dancers. And I believe Brian's going to introduce them again to us.
Yeah, actually, I haven't even moved from here. I've been sitting here watching all the great work that all the volunteers do down at Shaw Cable. And if you'd like to come down, volunteers, sign up, come and talk to Pat, Dale, or Dave, and sign up to volunteer. They treat you really good, and you learn a bunch of good stuff here. Country Pride dancers are with me. However, they're not dancing as yet. You'll have to wait till later in the show. And joining me right now is Rob Ironside. Rob from Country Pride Dances. How are you doing, Rob?
Great. How are you doing, Brian?
Good. And maybe you can tell us a little bit about the history of the club itself and how it started.
We got started about 5.5 years ago, 6 years ago. Just a bunch of people that got together and liked to dance, and we decided to form a club. And about a year later, we registered and we're a nonprofit organization now. And we've been doing stuff in the community now for quite a while and doing shows and demonstrations and that kind of stuff. But basically, it's a bunch of people that get together and just like to dance and have a good time.
Excellent.
And promote more of that.
So how are you with new members and stuff like that? New members come on up and...
Yeah, I think a lot of misconceptions people have is that you have to know how to dance before you join. Nothing could be further from the truth. A lot of our members got involved with the club just to learn how to dance, and then they get in as involved as they want. And so you don't need to know anything in order to get involved and to join.
So the club must be taking off, judging by the new outfits. Anybody who's seen the Country Pride dances before know that these are basically new. I haven't seen them before, so.
I'll let my wife Bonnie tell you about that.
Sure.
They're brand new. We had them finished a week before the competition in April. Myself and two of the other girls, Debbie and Rose on the team, and then three of the guys, we had them do all the hard work. They did the fray checking on the fringe, and we did all the sewing and stuff. But yeah, they're brand new outfits.
So you had a competition in April. Maybe you can tell a little bit about that.
we were in Calgary. There was four teams. We had a blast. We put a new routine on the floor, and we had 70% of our team was brand new people, and four of them are here with us today. And we just had a really good time, and they did very, very well. We were really proud of them.
Great, great. So you've got new plans for the club, and I see that the club will be holding something new in Red Deer coming this summer.
Yeah, what we've got planned this summer, it's something we have done. It's be our third annual this year, but we've moved it to August. It was in February here 2 years ago, and that's the Red Hot Dance Festival, and it's August 18th, 19th, and 20th coming up here this summer, and it's up at the Westerner Pavilion, and it's 3 days of workshops, demonstrations, a lot of fun that people can come in and just watch. And this year we've got a lot of stuff planned for the family. We've got something happening Saturday afternoon that's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to try to set a World Juniors line dance record. So for all the kids that may have taken any kind of line dancing in school, they can come up. They get in for free if they're going to participate in the line dancing portion of it. And the parents just have to buy a spectator pass, and that's only $6. And they can come up and they can be part of the weekend for us. And all of the kids that participate, they get a certificate for being part of the line dancing.
So anyone doesn't have to feel uncomfortable with it. The beginners, novices, people just wanting to learn, can come in and get a hold of you and come up to the festival and get involved in workshops.
We've got workshops targeted for people that don't know how to dance at all. So rah-rah beginners, if they want to come up and learn. And if people don't want to really take any workshops, if they just want to come up and they want to watch what's going on, we're going to have demonstrations going on all day long. So people can just pop in for a little while, watch a little bit of it, or come in and take a couple workshops.
Great.
And then we've got a big show and dance planned Saturday night, and we've got the Dean Mitchell Band that we're featuring Saturday evening for our dinner show and dance.
Good.
That's going to be a big, big show.
Yeah, great band, live music.
We also have a competition this year that's new for just brand new people out on the floor. All they have to do is come in, dance one dance, and they can enter their name for a trip to Truda, Nevada.
Oh,
yeah.
So, it doesn't matter what level of dancer you are, you can just come out and have a good time and put your name in for that.
Great. I'll just read the back of this pamphlet that you've made up here. Spectator pass. Maybe you can tell a little bit about what a spectator pass would...
A spectator pass. They can come in to watch the show. And we're going to be in the North Pavilion, like I said, so you can either sit at bleachers and watch what's going on, or you can sit at a table. And they'll participate in a lot of the mixers and demos and stuff that's going on in the main room. And we'll have a lot of door prizes we give away for that spectator pass. And you can get a spectator pass for Saturday or Sunday.
Great. And dances both Friday and Saturday? Friday dinner and dance Saturday.
Friday night's kind of our kickoff night, so we're having the Dean Mitchell Band will be in there Friday night, and we'll have just kind of an opening dance. And Saturday night is our big show. And we'll have a dinner and dance, and some of our dancers, we're flying dancers in from St. Louis. We're having some more from Washington, Portland, and they'll be up to do some entertainment. Plus, we're going to be highlighting a lot of the higher-level dancers here in Alberta. They're going to be performing at that show.
Great.
Plus, we'll probably have some other kind of surprises that are non-dance-related.
Oh, yeah, surprises and everything.
Our ceremonies coordinator, Cindy Glover, she's going to be coordinating that stuff. She'll be in for a treat. She's with one of the theater production companies in town, too.
We'll be able to see Cindy, and while they're kind of hiding in the darkness over there, so a shot right now wouldn't be too flattering. Okay. Maybe tell us a little bit about a dance hall crawl.
The dance hall crawl was a runaway success last year, and it's just kind of to introduce people to the different businesses in town, the different country western bars in town. So it's a kind of a thing we organize with buses, and everybody piles in, and we went around last year, and we really had a good time.
A little too much,
too much fun.
But that, anybody can go on that too. It
yeah.
starts at 7 o'clock Thursday night, and we're meeting at the Capri, and we leave from there.
Okay, now VIP 3-day pass. What would a person have for that expect?
With the VIP pass, and that's $40 for the whole weekend. That gets you into all of the workshops that you want to come to, gets you into both dances Friday and Saturday after the dinner show if you don't purchase a dinner show ticket. And you can come in and watch and participate all day Saturday and Sunday. Plus, like I say, we're giving away lots of door prizes and stuff, and that qualifies you for that too.
Once again, that's in August 18th, 19th, and 20th, a new event for Red Deer. Maybe you can tell us how to get a hold of you, or tickets, or information, pamphlets,
by all
order
means.
Forms.
telephone number you can call. The Country Pride Dance Club is listed in the phone book. It's under Dance Clubs, and the number for that is 342-5111, or you can call
346-5484. That's our home number.
346-5484. Or tickets are available through Ticketmaster, too. So you can go to Ticketmaster up at the Westerner and pick up tickets for the show.
And pamphlets are available pretty much anywhere?
Yeah, pretty much anywhere. We'll have them distributed all over the place.
Getting your job done distributing everything around? And yeah. Everybody know about
that's
that.
Why you have a team of people like our dance clubs. They help a lot.
There you go. Well, yeah,
they're amazing.
So that's Country Pride Dance. You'll be seeing them a little later here. And I'd like to thank Rob Ironside and
Bonnie.
Thank them for coming in, and we'll be seeing a display of their techniques in their dance club. And in August, a new event for Red Deer, 18th, 19th, and 20th, 3-day event. You can take in 1 day, 2 days, or anything like that. Once again, I'd like to thank Rob, and I think I kind of threw it over a little quickly. I got a little strange. However, thanks once again, Rob. And over to Pride Dance is here, but this is Bonnie Ironside, and she's going to take over and do some hosting of her own here. Rob's kind of jammed out. He does do hosting here and stuff like that. He's volunteer at Shaw as well. So here's Bonnie.
Hi, everybody. All I'm going to do is take a few minutes here and introduce you to everybody else on our team and give them a few minutes to say hello and tell you how long they've been with the club. First person here is Antoinette Holmes.
Hi, Bonnie.
Hi. The second person we have is Lori Coble.
Hi, Mom.
The third person we have is Cindy Glover.
Hello there.
And get out from behind me, Jim. The fourth person we have is Jim Swinson.
Hello.
This is the rest of our team. As you heard earlier, Cindy is our vice president of our club, so she's Rob's right-hand person. And now I'm going to hand the mic back over to Brian, because I don't do this very well.
Hey, how about that? Now I guess we can get them dancing a bit. I hear the monitor's ready, so if we're all queued up on the music, we'll let the Country Pride dancers take over, and I'll get the cord out of the way here and bounce out. Okay, I guess they couldn't hear me there. We've had little technical problems. I can almost hear the monitor coming up here, but yeah, we haven't got a studio monitor hooked up right now. And there we go. You can probably hear the feedback. So once again, here's the Country Pride Dancers. Take two.